In this session, we are going to discuss about the functions in PLSQL or in SQL. So what is mean by function? Function is nothing but a set of statements which are going to perform a specified task is called as a function. Now, into our SQL also, same thing. A standalone function is created using create function statement. The simplified syntax of the create or replace procedure statement is same as follows. So that means function and procedure both are same, but we have little differences between the function and procedure. Let me explain you later that one. So the creating of function syntax is same as your procedure only. So what is the syntax? Create or replace function, function name. Next, parameter name. So in this, always use in a function. And next, data type you have to specify. Next, return. Function always return a value. Remember, function always return a value. So you should say return, return variable name and the data type of that variable. Clear? Data type of that variable you have to specify. So the function must always return a value. You can use is, as, is you can write or as you can write. Begin, function body and end of the function. Clear? Simply create or replace function, function name, parameter list with respect to the data types, return, return type variable and the data type. Is or as, begin, function body, end function. Simple. Now, this is an example of the function. Now, here I am creating a function. Create or replace function. This is a total customer is the function name. So, I want to return how many number of customers are there in my customer table. Okay. That I want to return. Now, return number is, right? Total number is equals to 0. So I'm declaring a variable that is what? Total. And that is of which type? Number type. And that value initially I'm declaring as what? 0. So see here, return number. So this number you are using here. Select count star. Count is what? Count is a function that is going to count number of customers in a table into total. So what you are writing here? Whatever the count value you are getting from the select statement, like 20, 30, 40 customers, that 40 or 30 value I'm copying into which variable? Total variable. So where is your total variable? See, this is a total variable, right? From customers table and say end and close the function. Now that means what? Whatever the total number of customers you have in the count star, that I copy to a variable. So the variable where you declared? You declared this variable in a function, right? So this is a total is a variable, right? And this number is the data type. So here return data type I'm specifying. So which data type you are specifying? Number type. So number type variable is what? Total. So the total value will be returned. You no need to write explicitly total variable in the function declaration. Right? Now, after defining a function, what we have to do? We have to call the function. Right? Now, in this calling a function, how we are going to call? While creating a function, you give a definition of what the function to do, right? So when we create it, just we say that what is the task of the function. Now the next step is what? A called function performs defined task when its return statement is executed or when the last end statement is executed. It returns the program control back to the main program. That means what? When you say return or when you write end, this returns the value which you are giving back to the main program. So to call this function, so in the above example, the function total customers from anonymous block. So how to call the previous function? So anonymous block is nothing but I'm not declaring any block name for this. Simply I'm creating a block and I'm calling the previous function. So declare C number 2. Began C equals to total customers. So did you remember all the functions must be end with the parenthesis? That indicates that that is a function. So this total customers function is going to be called, and it returns the number of customers in a particular table, and that value will be copied to a variable C here, right? So now dbms underscore output dot put underscore line total number of customers colon C. That means what? Whatever the number is returned by this function is stored in C. That C I am displaying here. End and closing. So this block is where we have to create in SQL prompt or create in a notepad with the help of the CDMD, right? Now we'll see some of the differences between functions and the procedures. Later I'll show you function execution in the ORCID. See here, what is the first difference? A function is used to calculate using given inputs. A procedure is used to perform the certain task. That means what? Mainly the functions are used for the calculation purpose. Procedures are used to perform a operation like insertion, deletion, updation, alter, any adding a constraint, deleting a constraint, deleting a row, adding a row, every modification to a table. That means action is performed with the help of the procedures. Whatever the calculations you want to perform on a table, that we used functions, right? A function can be called by a procedure, but procedure cannot called by a function. Next, the DML statements cannot be executed within a function. What are the DML statements? Insert, update, delete. So you cannot perform these DML statements in function. You should perform only DML statements in procedures. Just now only I said you, whatever the operation like insertion, updation, deletion, perform in procedure. Calculations will be in the functions. A query, a function can be called within a query. A procedure cannot be called within a query. Call when a function is called. First, compiled before being called. A procedure is compiled once, can be called multiple times without being compiled. In the starting class only I told you. That means what? Is it a stored procedure? Means what? A procedure should be executed. That means compiled once, can run many times. But function, every time you should compile a function, you should run the function. But whereas procedure only compile once and can run multiple times. So this is a major difference between functions and procedures. Now in a return case, so all these are the headings, this call, query and the DML. A function returns a value and control to the calling function or to the code. A procedure returns the control but not any value to the calling function or the code. That means what? Function should always return a value. Procedure may or may not return the values. In try and catch case, so in the try and catch case, a function has no support for try and catch. A procedure has a support for try and catch. So in the procedure syntax, I have written exception. But that exception is allowed in procedure but not in functions. Next, select. So this select statement can have a function call. A select statement cannot have a procedure call. Simply when we discussed about the nested subqueries or queries, in a select statement we can call a function but we cannot call a procedure. Explicit transactions handling. So this is a topic, explicit transaction handling. A function cannot have explicit transaction handling, but a procedure can use explicit transaction handling. When you come for the transaction unit, I'll explain you this point. clear? So this is about differences between functions and the procedures. So to practice the functions in SQL, so first I started Oracle. I'm connecting to the server and I'm giving the username and the password. So we are running with the SQL server. So set server output on, so that our server is on to display the PL SQL statements. So first I have written already functions in this page. So in this function, what I'm doing, create or replace function, function name, return number, right? So is total number equals to zero, select the count star, that means how many number of employees are there in an employee one table. I'm counting and that value I'm copying to total variable of this function. So this total variable where I'm declaring, here I'm declaring. So this return total and n, that means the total value will be returned to where, from where you're calling this function to particular place, this value will be written. After writing this, just save this and close this. Now function is created. Now I have to compile the function. So in order to compile the function, so we have @ symbol and type the file name. So what is your file name? emp.sql. That means in your, we are not supposed to write the function name here. Whatever the file we have opened, notepad here, that file name you have to specify, so that whatever the content is there in the particular file, that will be compiled. Now see here, function created. After creating function, what we have to do? We have to make a call to the function. So in order to make a call to the function, I have created one more file, that is total.empsql. Wait a minute, I'll open. So this is the function. So I'm saving this, save. So I'm making it as save as total.emp.sql. Save. So total EMP file is created now. Just close this. After closing this, what we have to do? We have to execute this file. So if you execute this file, whatever the content is there in a particular file, that will be executed. So what we have in the emp.total.sql file, what we have in that file, we are calling a function. See, so what I have written here, I'm declaring a variable c as a number type, begin, c is equals to what, total emp colon, open the braces, close the braces and semicolon. That means what? Total EMP is a function which is declared in a EMP file. Now just print the number of employees in the table, that is C. So that means this function is going to return number of employees. That value I'm storing in C. Here I'm displaying the value of C and close this. Now just save it and close. Now I have to execute this file so that the function to be called. So in order to execute the files, whichever you are writing in a notepad, just @ file name. So what is the file name? total_emp.sql. Wait a minute. So that is showing some error. I'm creating this file again. The same thing I'm copying from there and I'm pasting here. And I'm renaming it as total_emp.sql. Save. So that is saved. So again, why it is showing? I'll check it. Now a file is opened, create, and whatever I have there, I am pasting here. Just I'm saving this tot.emp.save. Now this is saved. Now it will be executed. Now at the rate file name total emp.sql. Now see here, 11 number you are showing here. That means what? In your employee one table, we have 11 employees. Now just we'll check whether the emp table can have how many number of employees. Select star from emp1. Now check how many number of employees are here. 11 number of employees are there. This only I have seen here, 11. Clear? So how many number of employees are there? That many number of employees you are going to get in this. So this is about functions in SQL. Thank you. Thank you for watching my videos. If you like my videos, please share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.